Good morning to everyone. Ambassador Albert de Rosario, Chair of Strat-Base ADR Institute. Dr. Ernie Pernia, Professor Emeritus at UP, and of course, former Secretary of NEDA. Dindo Manhit, thank you kindly for your invitation to join the Pilipinas Conference 2021. Of course, to all our esteemed speakers and panelists. A very good morning to all of you, and congratulations on a rousing and provocative start to the five-day Pilipinas Conference 2021. As we close this opening day of this week-long summit, I'm actually quite heartened to see representatives from the public sector, the academe, and the private sector, all of them coming together to discuss the topic of sustainable economic recovery. You know, the task at hand really requires our collective commitment, all of us, to harness each of our sector's unique and complementary wisdom, resources, and energy to adequately address deep societal pain points towards national recovery and growth. Not one enterprise nor sector, however large and vigorous, really can do it alone and sustain these recovery efforts. However, taken together and working together, our individual contributions, however small, can add up to critical mass and sustainable momentum. The COVID-19 pandemic continues to rage around us. The toll has been heavy on lives and livelihood, on physical, mental, and financial health. I'm sure everybody here feels it. I need not belabor the troughs we went through, nor our country's standing international league tables as well on COVID-19 response and resilience. It's been a difficult period for all of us. Our recent indicators, however, give us reason to be cautiously optimistic. Caseloads are down to a fraction of the record high 23,000 daily new cases last September 18, and infection rates are now sub 10%. Clearly, the vaccines are working. Economic indicators are similarly, or consequently, picking up with the relaxation of alert levels and the easing of mobility restrictions. But caution, of course, abounds. Sustaining these gains is still uncertain due to the unpredictability of the transmission pattern of the virus and the recurring lockdowns in response to surges. We've only to look at recent surges in Germany, Russia, and Eastern Europe to be reminded of the volatility. If there's one good thing the pandemic did, it brought about an unprecedented level of cooperation among private sector companies and between the public sector, the private sector, and the academe community. One such example last year, of course, was Project Ugnayan, and many of us were involved there. All in all, about 270 private businesses quickly and generously came together to raise donations and devise a way to distribute aid at scale. With the help of the network of Caritas Manila, we distributed food aid to over 14 million of the most economically vulnerable Filipinos. It was a wonderful moment for the private sector to come together. The private sector understood that it would take our government some time to realign national budgets and get their requisite approvals, and so we voluntarily stepped in to bridge the need. Since then, private businesses have continued to help capacitate the Philippines' COVID-19 response initiatives, building and donating biomolecular labs, hospitals and isolation facilities, supplying medical supplies, and of course, aid for disaster relief. This year, the private sector again partnered with government on our national vaccination program. Early in the planning and procurement stages and continuing through to the current implementation phase for large-scale inoculation. The private sector ordered 13 million vaccines in January and February, of which some 25 to 30% have arrived. In our particular case, the Ayala Group ordered about a million doses. While waiting for our orders to arrive, we've been partnering with LGUs to vaccinate their constituents, and we have since administered over 600,000 inoculations just within our group. I dare say that the private sector has established itself, I believe, as a reliable partner of the government in addressing the people's most urgent pain points, such as poverty, hunger, health emergencies, and of course, unemployment. The scale of the private sector's response to the COVID-19 crisis, also in partnering with the government of the Philippines, has been noted by international observers. Just the other day, the Boston Consulting Group emphasized this, and they consider it to be unprecedented and perhaps a worthy case study for review and adaptation in other countries, and on other possible applications requiring a whole of society approach. However, I know all of us can do more, and I'm heartened by the unprecedented generosity of the private sector in providing philanthropic emergency relief, and at how we're broadening our scope in interpreting inclusive stakeholder capitalism. However, for impact to be sustainable, the social contract of private corporations needs to go beyond philanthropy and corporate social responsibility actions like emergency aid relief, annual volunteer days, and even company-funded vaccines. These are certainly important and provide channels for employees and partners to participate and make a difference. But we must also seek to direct and pivot our business purpose, our portfolios, and our practices at their core to help solve society's major pain points, to adapt to the changing consumers and market conditions, and to provide more and more equitable access to quality basic services. Only if our whole entire ecosystem prospers will we be able to continue to contribute to society through job generation, the manufacture and sale of products and services, the payment of taxes, and continue attracting investors and providers of capital in a sustainable fashion. I note that the agenda for the next few days dedicates some time for environmental sustainability. Climate discussions have been front and center in these past few days due to the recent discussion at COP26. The four goals of the summit were crisply stated. First, to secure global net zero by mid-century and keep 1.5 degrees within reach. Second, to adapt to protect communities and natural habitats. Third, to mobilize finance. And fourth, to work together to deliver. The summit's four main goals were so simply stated, belying the massive challenges we all face in delivering the desired results. Indeed, some say that even beyond the raging COVID-19 pandemic, the devastating impact of climate change is the existential challenge of our generation. At the Ayala Group, we clearly see climate change as both a global environment risk as well as a business risk. If we do not take bold action, our business models will not be sustainable. Climate change is here, and intervention is imperative. However, I would like to add that the devastating impact of climate change is just one among a wider set of challenges falling under the ambit of sustainability. As with many other partners and like-minded peers, we view sustainability with a broader lens, covering climate change, but also inclusivity and equality. In quite a few areas, the pandemic has worsened the fissures of inequality that were already present in our society. Squarely addressing the challenges in these areas is the only way to create sustainable impact in its broadest and most inclusive sense. Again, in this sphere, unprecedented collaboration is demanded of us, the private sector, government, and civil society, both locally and globally. All of us have to work together. Let me end by quoting from the Vision 2050 framework of the World Business Council for Sustainable Development, WBCSD, of which the Ayala Group is a member. In the framework, the WBCSD elegantly captures what sustainable impact in its various facets should be about. And I quote from them, 9 billion people living well within planetary boundaries. For us in the Philippines, that means 110 million people living well within planetary boundaries. No one left behind. On that note, congratulations on the successful kickoff of the Pilipinas Conference 2021. Over the next 4 days, as you continue with the conference, I wish you firm resolve, robust discussions, and concrete and measurable commitments in sustaining economic recovery post-pandemic towards 2022 and beyond. Certainly, you can count on the Ayala Group to remain a committed partner in scaling our collective efforts towards inclusive national recovery and growth. Thank you for this invitation. Delighted to be here with you today, and please enjoy the conference. Thank you.